All right, guys, finally time to put the rear end back together in the Mustang. Here's what we're doing. We got a Strange Engineering 35 spline axle spool and C-cup eliminator package with a 5/8 wheel stud. This is a Motive 48 gear. They don't come looking this nice from Motive. TRE, Team Rip Engineering, is a local transmission shop to me. They helped me out with a lot of my gear stuff. We actually went down there and magnaflexed my old ring and pinion, the 410 ratio that was in it, and it was cracked in a bunch of places. So they finished those gears up nice for me. First thing we got to do here for the C-clip eliminator is cut this flange off of here. That's just the end of the tube from that center ring out. And this ring here, leave that behind, and that will locate the C-clip eliminator. So I'm going to get that cut off. All right, got that axle end all cleaned up, looking decent. You do have to measure this step height. They want it between 100 and 130 thou. This, before I even touched it, was already 97, so I'm hoping that's not going to be a problem. But a little nerve-wracking, but not much I can do about it. So now we got to put the 5/8 studs, the screw-in studs, into the axle before you put the C-clip eliminator axle bearing stuff on the end of the axle, because if you do that first, you can't put the studs in. So I'm going to get the studs put in. All right, got the stud screwed in and torqued. Got the ABS adapter. Obviously, I didn't put the reluctor wheel on there, but the sealed axle bearing actually seals against that. And the bearing setup and the safety sleeve there, which is called the wedding ring, is on there. This is just floating. Obviously, this is the what bolts to the housing side, slides over that bearing like so. You get the idea. So that stuff's done. Next thing we got to do is put the bearings on the spool here and get the gear set pattern checked and installed, and then we can check the axle engagement. So I couldn't figure out how to hold the diff and torque it because it's a spool, so it's round. So I stuck the axle and did a thing. Don't judge me, it works. All right, got the gear set in here. Stuff is sure nice looking. So check out the pattern. Coast side looks good. Drive side looks great too. Everything's in the center. It's got 7 thou backlash, which spec on this is 8 to 12, but we're just gonna run it. So now I gotta stick the axles in there and check the spline engagement on the spool. All right, so here's the axle engagement. I just put grease on it, and you can see it pushed the grease all the way down to there. So that is how much engagement we have, and they're not bottomed out in there, so that's good to go. So now I've just gotta put silicone on all of these surfaces, this surface here, and then the surface between the brake plate and the bearing. Gonna put a thin film on this here, even though there's an O-ring there, just a little bit extra to make sure it stays sealed. Then we can put this thing back together, put some lube in it, and hit the track. Well, maybe not yet, but we're getting there. All right, she's going back together. Got the brakes out. I forgot I had to drill the rotors out for the 5/8 studs, obviously, dummy. Got the cover on it, pouring some Rev-X 8090 in there, and then I got the drive shaft in it. All right, honestly, one of my favorite things about doing all this stuff with the 5/8 stud and whatever, check this out. No more shank-style lug nuts. It's just simple. Well, if I could learn how to start the nut, it's as simple as that. But that's it for the C-clip eliminator 48 gear swap for this thing. Going to get the wheels on it and torqued, and yeah.